Hello, I'm Ari Kagan. I'd like to tell you about some important news about Brooklyn, about New York City, what is going on. To begin with, I really hope that Mayor Eric Adams will veto several bills passed by New York City Council in December, especially bill related to NYPD. As you know, they passed a legislation that will require every police officer to report race, gender, or age of every person they do interaction with, which means police officers will not have time to do actual police work, to patrol streets, to patrol subways, to investigate crimes. Instead, they will be writing whole day in cars or in precincts. They will be doing paperwork, very often using overtime, just to write how old are you, what is your race, what is your ethnicity, what is your gender. That's not the purpose of a police force. The purpose of police force is to fight crime, not to do paperwork, bureaucratic stuff. This is not like clerks in the office. We're talking about police officers. I really hope that mayor will veto this legislation and that city council will not be able to override this veto. I know that Republicans voted against it, and a few Democrats voted against it. So in total, it was, I believe, 35-9 about this legislation. But I hope that some Democrats will change their mind and will not vote to override this veto. Very important that this bill will not become a law because it will affect our public safety. And also second bill that also was passed in December related to safety inside Rikers Island jail. They voted to ban solitary confinement, restrictive housing. I visited Rikers Island several times, and I can tell you that very, very important to have this tool for local guards, because correction officers, because if person committed violent crime while in jail, while waiting for a trial, this person should be separated from general population. This person should be punished. Because if we abolish all kinds of punishment, no consequences, then it will be complete chaos and very serious violence inside the jail. Even federal monitor that currently overseeing our Rikers Island also came out against this bill, saying it will increase violence in Rikers Island, not decrease. So I hope both of these bills will be vetoed by mayor and will not be able, city council will not be able to override this veto. All we need is one or two common sense Democrats to stand up and to say they support public safety. It's very important for public safety on the street, on the inside subway, inside our houses, and of course inside Rikers Island. Second topic I would like to talk to, what's going to happen in May. As you know, in May, this ill-conceived plan called congestion pricing will take an effect. $15 for every car and $36 for every truck that entering Manhattan, which is absolutely insane. It will punish so many middle-income, middle-class New Yorkers, business owners, even people who wanted to visit medical centers for medical appointments. That's terrible. This congestion pricing is insane. Several lawsuits filed by the state of New Jersey, by several organizations. Many business associations are against it. But by the end, it will affect every New Yorker because businesses will not be taken lightly that they need to pay $36 to bring merchandise to Manhattan or to use trucks. They will increase prices for everything. So everybody will suffer. So it's going to start in May if nothing will change. And it was passed by New York State Legislature and approved by federal government. And I'm totally against congestion pricing. I know that all Republicans in New York City Council are against congestion pricing. And business associations are against congestion pricing. I believe it will negatively affect quality of life of all New Yorkers if it will take an effect in May. Another topic I would like to talk about is this demonstrations that, and rallies going all over New York City of so-called pro-Palestinian demonstrators. I say pro-Palestinians because they very often hold signs anti-Semitic signs, anti-American signs, anti-Israel signs, and they're like not shy about it, you know. They're very often they're praising Hamas. They're saying by any means resistance, by any means necessary, from the river to the sea. They're chanting slogans of Hamas. And recently, you know, they were engaged in completely criminal activities near JFK Airport, which created tons of problems for everyone. 60 flights were canceled. And just several days ago, they marched in front of Sloan Memorial Kettering Cancer Center. And my own mother received a treatment in this center, had an operation on brain tumor. And I'm very grateful, forever grateful, to Sloan Memorial Kettering Cancer Center for giving my mother 3 more years of life. And my mother-in-law also went to this life-saving medical institution, prominent, worldwide known. Everybody knows Memorial Sloan Kettering Center. So these pro-Palestinian demonstrators not just marched in front of this medical center, but also screamed and yelled, including at children, at medical staff, at nurses. Oh, you're complicit to genocide. You're not innocent. You're doing genocide. So they tried, it was a psychological warfare, an abuse of patients and medical staff at a very prominent cancer treatment center. Shame on them, shame on these demonstrators for attacking cancer center. What is next? So I believe that NYPD should have much stronger response to arrest people who are engaging in illegal criminal activities. I'm not even talking about now moral situation, which is totally immoral, in my opinion, what they did in front of the Sloan Memorial Kettering Center, but also very often illegal and criminal activities when they block traffic, when they put fires on the roads, when they're blocking all roads to JFK Airport, blocking Brooklyn Bridge, etc. So it's illegal. So you need a permit to have a demonstration. I know you need to apply for a permit to have even a very peaceful rally. So why they're allowed to do all of this, destroying life of New Yorkers? Oh, we wanted to everybody to see how horrible is it in the Middle East, that Israel committing crimes, etc., etc. So I'm not going to even comment about their statements, because I don't want to dignify their statements about what's going on in the Israel-Hamas war in Gaza. But I wanted to say that here in New York, we have to stand strong against all of these illegal disruptions. If they don't have a permit, if they're like blocking roads, bridges, airports, verbally abusing medical staff at cancer center, all decent people should say that's absolutely unacceptable. So I'm saying it's absolutely unacceptable. And finally, many of you ask me what I'm doing right now, because since January 1st, I'm no longer New York City councilman in Southern Brooklyn. I would like to, first of all, one more time to thank you for your tremendous support. I'm still very, very proud to receive more than 8,200 votes in 47th district in Brooklyn last year. And very grateful for everyone who gave me opportunity. It was a privilege of my lifetime to be councilman for 2 years, to represent beautiful communities of Southern Brooklyn. And since January 1st, I'm working as a public affairs director for a prominent home care agency, Welcome Care, which is in business for more than 20 years. And I'm public affairs director. I have a major from Baruch College. I graduated with major in marketing and advertising. And now I'm going to use this major, my knowledge, my skills. And also I'm working part-time for a Republican minority leader in New York City Council, Joe Borelli, who is a leader of Republicans in New York City Council. I work for him part-time, helping with constituent work and any other assignments. So I'm okay. I'm doing fine. I'm very grateful. And I also wanted to use this opportunity. It's my first program in 2024 to wish you a happy and healthy new year. Only the best. I'm Ari Kagan, and stay well. Wish you only good things in new year. Thank you.